the Khaled bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation surveys coral reefs around the world. The foundation's scientists measure the reef in three main ways. They count the number of fish. They record what's on the bottom. And they take note of species of coral and invertebrates.
Things like lobsters and conch and sea urchins that move around. You know, a big tuna.
Chief scientist Dr. Andy Bruckner discusses the foundation's survey methods with high school teacher Mike Trimble.
And so what I'll show you are the different pieces of equipment we use to do those surveys. Okay. All we need to do a fish census is we have a transect tape. The tape is 30 meters long. Then we have what we call a T-bar. So the T-bar is a meter long, and each one of these are 10 centimeters long. At the beginning of my line, I put the weight down. And what I'm doing is I'm swimming very slowly. And as I'm swimming, the tape unravels. So I know when I get to the end of the tape, I've gone 30 meters. I take about 8 minutes to do a 30 meter transect, and I'm looking at all the fish that are in a square. You're only looking at a 2 meter by 2 meter window, and you're about 1 meter to 2 meters off the bottom. Because you don't want to see what's way up in the water column. You want to see the things that are actually active down on the reef, that are coming in, feeding on the reef, moving through the reef, looking for food, you know, all those species that will play an active role in the reef. We record the type of fish we see. We want to know how many are there, but we also need to know how large they are, because that gives us what's called biomass. It'll tell us how much overall weight all those fish, because you can convert size to weight. And so you hold this out in front of you, and you use this as a scale to gauge their size. And we record it in 5 centimeter intervals. And so by having this, you can tell how large the fish is once you practice a little. And the reason we use this is because everything underwater is magnified. And so when you look at a fish without having a scale bar, you'd think they're larger than they really are. And so this makes sure that it's very accurate. We want to know exactly what's on the bottom. We're looking at whether the bottom is rock, whether the bottom is sand, or whether it's rubble, which is broken up coral that's loose. And then also we want to know what organisms have colonized the bottom. So we want to know how much seaweed is there and what types. Then we also want to know how much of the bottom is covered by coral, how much of it is sponge, how much of it is sea urchin, all the other invertebrates. To do this transect, we're using a 10 meter long lead line. But you start at one end and you run this out, and you want to keep it in a straight line. The reason we use lead line is because it's slightly weighted, but it's not so heavy that it makes it difficult for you when you're diving. But by being weighted, it sits right on the bottom. So we have a 10 meter line, and we're assessing what's under every 10 centimeters, so we get 100 points along that line. And what we do is we record exactly what's under this. We record what type of bottom it is, whether it's rock or sand or rubble. We record what organism is there. And so we'll do that for each of these points, and then we have to do a minimum of 6 of these on one reef, preferably more, in order to get an indication of the cover of these different organisms. When we finish that, you also see that we have a quadrat. This square is 25 centimeters on a side. So it's 25 by 25 by 25. We use this to assess how many baby corals are on the reef. We've color-coded this. Each one of these black lines represents 1 meter. And at that meter mark, we'll place our quadrat. What we're looking for is baby corals, corals that are 2 to 4 centimeters in diameter, and then 0 to 2 centimeters. And we record what species and how many are in each of these quadrats. And that gives us an indication of how many new corals have settled on the bottom to replace those that have died. We look at the corals, and then we look at what's on the bottom. The large invertebrates, things like lobsters and conch and sea urchins that move around. We use the same 10 meter line But what you'll notice is it's a little different. It's also lead line, but it only has points every meter. For our coral survey, we want to look in a belt. And the 1 meter bar has a tape measure on it, marked off in centimeters. And what I will do is I will swim along this transect and I will record every coral that I see within a half a meter of either side of the line. And so by running through this whole transect, I'm doing a 10 square meter area. So it's 10 meters long by 1 meter wide. I'm assessing every single coral. And so I will swim along and I come to a coral and then I measure the coral. We can't tell how old a coral is, but size is an indication of their age because they only grow on the order of 1 to 2 centimeters a year. A coral that's 25 centimeters in diameter would be about 25 years old for some of these slow-growing massive corals. And so it gives us an idea of how long ago they settled on the bottom, how well they're growing. This is for the bigger corals, and it's to tell you what your meter is. So we also have a little 15 centimeter ruler. And I do the same thing. I'll measure the 3 measurements for each coral using this ruler. And then in addition to knowing how big they are, we want to know how healthy they are. And so for every coral we look at, we carefully scan that coral and look at if it's completely live or whether parts of it have died. Because corals are colonial animals. They can get sick and half of them or a quarter of them may die, but the rest of it may survive and that could ultimately regrow back over its old skeleton or it continues to grow in another direction. After we finish that, we're looking for those big invertebrates. We're looking for lobsters because they're commercially important. We're looking for conch because people harvest those. And then we're looking in particular in the Caribbean for the long-spined black sea urchin. It's called diadema. And the reason for that is those are the most important invertebrate herbivore. So they eat more algae than anything else that's on the reef that's not a fish. In every 10 meter long by 1 meter square area that we're looking at, we record how many of those organisms we see.
By conducting coral surveys, the Khalid Bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation provides tools and information to help protect coral reefs around the world. Learning how to conduct your own surveys can help you make observations about resources near you. To find out more about what you can do to help coral reefs, visit the Living Oceans Foundation website.